This video will demonstrate how to install Leviton Arc Fault Circuit Interrupter Outlets, Slim Series Ground Fault Circuit Interrupter Outlets, and Dual Function AFCI-GFCI Outlets. AFCIs and GFCIs are used for different types of protection and are required by the current National Electrical Code for use in specific areas of a home. Some areas now require both AFCI and GFCI protection. Have the following tools on hand: a flathead screwdriver, a Phillips head screwdriver, electrician's pliers, a wire stripper, electrical tape, a handheld voltage tester, and properly sized wire connectors. Warning: to avoid fire, shock, or death, be sure to turn off the power at the circuit breaker or fuse and test that power is off before wiring a device. Use a handheld voltage tester to confirm that there is no power flowing. AFCI, GFCI, and dual function outlets feature what is called feed-through protection. This means the protection in the device can be extended to other outlets on the circuit that are downstream from the device being installed. This is done by attaching the wires that lead to the downstream outlets onto the terminal that are marked load. These devices offer the option of either wrapping leads around the terminal screws or using an external backwire clamp. Begin by identifying cables and wires. It is important not to install one of these devices in an electrical box containing more than four wires, not including the grounding wires, or cables with more than two wires, not including the grounding wire. If you see either of these scenarios in the electrical box you are working on, contact an electrician. If you're not sure which wires in the box are the line wires coming from the load center and which are the load wires going to additional receptacles downstream, you'll need to identify which are the line leads and which are the load leads. To do this, detach one white wire and hot wire from the outlet and cap each one separately with a wire connector. Make sure they're from the same cable. Reinstall the receptacle in the electrical box, attach the wall plate, and restore the power at your service panel. Determine if power is flowing to the outlet. If it is, the capped wires are the load wires. If not, the capped wires are the line wires. In this instance, the outlet is powered, so the line wires are connected. Turn the power off at your service panel. Label the line and load wires, and then remove the outlet. To terminate this device, take one of the conductors and strip the insulation from the conductor the length shown on the strip gauge on the rear of the device. Next, simply insert the conductor under the clamp. There are guide channels to help keep the wire in place. Use a screwdriver and turn the terminal screw clockwise to tighten the conductor under the clamp. Give a tug afterwards to assure that the conductor is terminated. Follow the exact same procedure with any other conductors. The last step is to terminate the ground conductor, which is the green or bare copper conductor. Ground screws are always hexagonal in shape and colored green. Use a screwdriver, rotating clockwise, to secure the wire to the terminal. This device is now terminated. Secure the device in the wall box and cover with a wall plate. The device is now ready for use. We recommend you conduct a quick test of the reset functionality. Plug a lamp into the outlet. Restore the power at the service panel. Ensure that the device is still in the tripped condition by pressing the test button. Press the reset button fully. If the lamp turns on and the indicator light turns on, the device has been installed correctly. For more detailed information on specific termination methods or wiring of Leviton devices, visit www.leviton.com/protection.